Now, at the platform level, what are you guys betting on? Like, what are the hot technologies? Should I just, I can give you a list, and let's see, thumbs up, thumbs down, where you go. So let's start with one. So we see adaptive intelligence, thumbs up, thumbs down.
Thumbs up. I mean, adaptive intelligence, machine learning, I think will fundamentally transform the way the apps work today.
Okay.
Fundamentally.
Blockchain, where does blockchain sit on this one?
Blockchain, I wish I could get a thumbs up, but I'm gonna keep it somewhere thumbs and middle.
We're not ready yet in terms of where that technology is headed so far.
You know, I think the technology is okay. I think, you know, we built out some things in the supply chain area for blockchain.
Yes.
Things like genealogy tracking for food and drug or pharmaceuticals. There's other areas where you can do it. It's just the adoption within the communities that need to make it happen when blockchain isn't there yet from the businesses. I don't think it's a technology inhibitor, but I certainly think it's a questionable, how about this? There's gonna be some area where blockchain really takes off. I'm just not sure what it will be.
No problem. So what about IoT?
IoT thumbs up. Probably not as fundamentally transforming as I think machine learning and AI apps will be because those are sort of pervasive, but I'll tell you a story. So it was funny, we were building our IoT apps, and I said, okay, this is great, it's looking good, but how long do we have to wait for everybody to have the telemetry on all their devices in their supply chain? Well, I was told, actually, no, like most of those things are there, and most organizations sort of either don't even collect it, telemetry, or they collect it and put it in some big data warehouse, or they're, you know, do nothing, or they've got that, and then they're trying to manually build some applications. So I think the adoption is gonna be relatively rapid because the software is ironically behind some of the telemetry in terms of packaged products. But it's really in that sort of supply chain space, at least for now. I know people are talking about doing some things around people in HR. We'll see how that takes off, but definitely a thumbs up.
Well, you know, bandwidth and battery life, those are the biggest factors of any kind of adoption where
we
are. So there's 5G then. 5G is coming, we've got multiplexing.
Yes.
Maybe that'll help out with some of this IoT stuff.
I think it will help out not only with the IoT stuff, I think it'll help out with the pervasiveness of the UI stuff, right? I mean, that's you're always with mobile, offline, not offline, you have the speed. You know, we're pretty much getting to the state that the vast majority of the world, you're going to have a very, very fast connection on, you know, a very, very inexpensive device. When you have that and you have different interfaces, whether it be Siri or whether it be Alexa on your phone or whether it be the Google Assistant on the phone, all of a sudden that opens up a whole new set of UI possibilities.
Now, how far are we from quantum? Way out there now?
Further out. From the apps perspective, we're going to be at the end of that type of scale.
But your point here is basically like no matter what happens, right, these are innovations you guys have that you can put into the platform over time. Whatever new disruptive exponential technology pops in, that's part of the benefits of the cloud.
Well, that's sort of, you know, going back to your very first point when you said, you know, SaaS, and I said, yes, it's really SaaS versus, if you're a customer today and you're looking at moving to SaaS, now maybe your thumbs down on all of them, right? Maybe you don't believe in AI, maybe IoT is not going to be applicable to you, maybe you don't believe in blockchain, et cetera. But boy, you don't know what's coming in 2 years, whether it's quantum or something else.
You don't.
And particularly if you're really large. So I get this all the time. Hey, we're really large, we're really complex, not sure we're going to get the benefits of those. My answer is pretty simple. If you're really large and really complex, you better start moving to the cloud today. Because if you're not, you have to believe that the things we've talked about don't apply to you. And you probably also have to believe things that are coming around the next 2 years don't apply to you, because the speed is incredible of technology change and business change, the business disruption.